Welcome to Revelation Unraveled. I am your host, William Tapley, also known as the Third Eagle of the Apocalypse and the co-prophet of these end times. This will be part four in my series, Debunking the Flat Earth Model. And it is a psyops, in my opinion. I'm not sure if the government is behind it, or Google, or maybe it's a test by some university. In any case, I have discovered that they do not accept any high-tech refutation of their ideas. If it's been invented in the last 500 years, they do not accept it. You can't bounce radio signals off the moon, for example, and try to convince them that it is actually 238,000 miles from Earth. So, if all they are going to accept are sticks and stones, I came up with a solution, and that is a sundial. A sundial is thousands of years old. It does not use any electricity. It does not use any lens. It has no moving parts. It should satisfy the flat earthers. So let's take a look at the features of a sundial, because they prove that the Earth is a globe, and the way a sundial works could not work if the Earth were actually flat. Now, I got this image of a sundial from a Hack a Week website, and I'll put a link below to his video, because he explains how to make a sundial, if you're interested. And he has this set up for North Carolina, which is 35 degrees latitude. But I want you to notice how the angles are different between the sunrise and sunset hours and the noon hour. In other words, the angles are wider towards the morning and the evening, and they are much smaller around noon. And of course, the reason for this is because we live on a spherical globe and we do not live on a flat earth. A sundial would not work if the earth were in fact flat. So now let's take a closer look at a global earth diagram, and we'll see that the shadows of a stake increase geometrically towards the evening or morning hours. On our planet, which is a globe, the sun's rays come directly because the sun is 93 million miles away from Earth. And the shadow on a stake every hour increases towards either the sunrise or the sunset. But it increases geometrically. The shadow at 8 a.m. is much longer than at 9 a.m. And the difference is much more than the shadow between noon and 11 a.m. The shadows on a stake at hourly intervals prove a global Earth, and they debunk a flat Earth. So now let's look at the diagram of a flat Earth model, and you will see that the shadows would have to be equidistant. On a theoretical flat Earth model, the sun cruises 3,000 miles over the flat surface, and the shadows on a stake increase towards sunrise or sunset, just as on a global model. However, the shadows are equidistant. They do not increase geometrically. This could never happen with a sundial. On a sundial, the angles show that the shadow increases geometrically. The flat Earth model is bogus. Now, I have discovered that you don't even need a sundial to prove that the Earth is a globe. All you need is a stake, a sunny day, and a flat surface, like in this case, a tennis court. And this, I hope, is low-tech enough for you flat earthers. In fact, if you want to perform this experiment yourself, it's very easy. Just watch. The vertical stake I used was a PVC pipe, approximately 5.5 feet tall. And I began at 9 o'clock. I think my iPhone reads 9:01. And I marked the tip of the shadow of the stake at 9:01 with a short stick, and every hour after that until noon. My iPhone reads 10 a.m. and there was enough sun so that I could mark the tip of the shadow of the stake at exactly 10 o'clock. And of course, you can see the movement of the shadow between 9 a.m. and 10 a.m. is quite significant. Once again, at 11 a.m., I hit the hour on the dot, and I marked the length of the shadow of the stake. It was not too sunny, it was just right. But as you can see, the distance between the two shadows is significantly less. I couldn't get the iPhone to show the time at noon, however, the fire siren went off, so I know it was exactly noon. And as you can see, when I mark the tip of the shadow with another short stick, the distance is significantly less than the other two distances. At the end of the 3 hours, it's obvious that the four location points are not equidistant apart as they would have to be if we lived on a flat Earth. Just like on a sundial, the shadows are closer together near noon and geometrically farther apart closer to sunrise. On this experiment, the shadows were 32 inches apart from 11 to noon. They were 40 and a half inches apart from 10 to 11, and nearly 70 inches apart early in the morning from 9 a.m. until 10. So in conclusion, in the interest of telling everyone the truth, try this experiment yourself. It's very easy to carry out, very low tech. All you need is a stake, a sunny day, and a level place. And then you will have an answer to the flat earthers, not that they are going to listen, because they are part of a psyops. But you don't have to be fooled any longer. The earth is a globe. That's the way Almighty God made it. And I hope you all come to understand that. I know my subscribers already do. In fact, they're getting on my case because I make too many of these flat earth debunk videos and not enough Bible prophecy videos. So I hope this is the last one. And if you would like more information about my ministry, visit my thirdeaglemedia.com website.